Dear children, welcome to all in SST class. Today we will read and learn The Great Indian Desert. Look at your book. The northwestern part of our country is comprised of a large area of dry land covered with sand. This is called the Great Indian Desert or the Thar Desert. So, in our country have a desert. It is known as Thar Desert or Great Indian Desert. This region is mostly hot and dry with very little rainfall. As a result, cultivation is scarce here. Means there have no cultivation in desert. Very few plants like thorny bushes and shrubs grow here. Therefore, it is thinly populated. People are found living around an oasis. This is a place where the groundwater comes to the surface. Children, here see oasis. Oasis means a place in desert where the groundwater comes to the surface. A camel is a very important animal of the desert. You know, camel is a very important animal. It is called the sheep of the desert. It is used as an important means of transport. It carries people and goods across the desert. It can live without water for several days. Children, remember, camel can live without water or food for several days. So it is called the sheep of the desert. Next, the southern plateau. The southern part of India is conical in shape and is known as peninsular India. A piece of land surrounded by water bodies on three sides is called a peninsula. So, the southern India is a peninsula. Peninsula means a piece of land surrounded by water bodies on three sides is called a peninsula. The Indian peninsula is surrounded by the Bay of Bengal in the east, the Arabian Sea in the west, and the Indian Ocean in the south. So three sides is surrounded by water, east, west, and south. The land here is flat, uneven, and higher than the plains. Such land is called a plateau. What is plateau? The land is uneven and higher than the plains. This land is called plateau. The southern plateau is also known as the Deccan Plateau. The soil here is hard and rocky. Hence, this area is less fertile than the plains. Many rain-fed rivers like Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, etc. flow through the Deccan Plateau. Most of them dry up in summer. Means these rivers are dry up in summer season. There are thick forests where many tribes live. This region is very rich in minerals. Next we see the coastal plains. On either side of the Deccan Plateau are low mountains called the Western Ghat and the Eastern Ghat. Between the Eastern Ghats and the Bay of Bengal and the Western Ghats and the Arabian Sea lies narrow strips of plain lands. They are known as the Eastern Coastal Plain and the Western Coastal Plain, respectively. This region has a moderate climate. Moderate means neither too hot nor too cold. Next, islands. An island is a piece of land surrounded by water on all sides. Means a piece of land surrounded by water on all sides is called an island. There are two main groups of island in India. First, the Lakshadweep island are located in the Arabian Sea, and another is the Andaman and Nicobar island in the Bay of Bengal. You remember it. Since the land surface is not the same throughout the India, so in our country, the land surface is not same everywhere. The climate conditions are also different. Means we feel the climate or we see the climate condition also different in different parts of the country. The mountains have a cold climate almost throughout the year. On the other hand, in the northern plains, the summers are very hot while the winters are cold. In the coastal areas, the climate is moderate. Moderate means, you know, neither too hot nor too cold. The Thar desert is very hot and dry with very little rainfall. Children, we stop here. Next class, we see another work. Thank you.